Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in today's class we will be dealing with Tel Aviv on tenterhooks, written by Vijay Prasad. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand three important aspects about the Israel and Palestine conflict. First of all, we need to understand about the division of the territory under Israel and Palestine. Then we need to understand about the atrocities that the Israel had committed on the Palestinians. Atrocities. And then we need to understand the changed stance of United States of America and how this changed stance of United States of America is not going to sustain for a long period of time. So the changed stance basically of the United States of America is just for a shorter period of time. The changed stance. Now these three aspects will help you to understand this entire issue about Israel and Palestine. Now when it comes to the conflict between Israel and Palestine, the entire diplomatic landscape is polarized. Now what is meant by polarization of diplomatic landscape? It means half of the world is supporting the existence, the legitimacy of Palestine, and half of the world is standing behind Israel. So the world is completely divided how the justice should be unleashed. Justice kaise hona chahiye Israel aur Palestine ke issue mein? Pura dunya is cheez ko leke bata hua hai. Now the Muslim world supports the cause of Palestine, be it the Shia world or be it the Sunni world. The entire Muslim realm is behind the Palestinians. On the other hand, we have Israel, and Israel is being supported by the capitalist club, because the support for the Israel came after the ending of the Second World War. This is very important to understand. The support for Israel came after the ending of the Second World War. Now why the Western countries, why the capitalist countries like United States of America, or for that matter the European Union countries, why they support the cause of Israel? They support the cause of Israel because after ending of the Second World War, there was a fear that the communism might take over the Middle East countries, and they were looking out for some support system, and this support system came in the form of supporting a new, a budding Jewish nation. So it was the support for the Jewish nation that had helped in containing communism to envelop entire Middle East. So this has been the reason. This is what has sustained the support of United States of America for Israel. Now going back in the history and understanding the territory of this entire. Now in the east of the Mediterranean we have a landmass, and this landmass presently it constitutes of Israel, and it also constitutes of two relics of Palestine, old Palestine. And now these two relics are, one is West Bank and the other is Gaza. And the governance of the West Bank and the Gaza is carried out by two outfits who are fighting for the cause of Palestine. Two outfits hain jo Palestine ke cause ko leke work karte rahe hain, usko support karte rahe hain. Kaun se ye outfits hain? Number one is Hamas. Now this Hamas is more radical in nature. It adopts fundamentalist ideology. It adopts Islamic ideology, to fight against the aggression of Israel. And the second is Fatah group. Now this group is the group of Yasser Arafat. Now Yasser Arafat, he died fighting for the cause of Palestine. So the entire territory is divided into three parts. One is the Israel, the complete Israel as a country, and the two relics of Palestine. Now there is an important date to understand in the issue, in the conflict of Israel and Palestine, and the date is 1967. This is the year, very important year, if you want to understand how the things have taken a bloody turn. 1967 was the year when Israel took over these two relics of Palestine, that is West Bank and Gaza, and Israel began to hegemonize these two land masses. And how this was hegemonized? This was hegemonized in the form of setting up settlements of Israel in these two lands. Pehle to Israel ke paas koi landmass hi nahi tha. 1890 se leke 1948 tak jitne bhi Jews hain duniya mein, wo sare migrate karna shuru kiye kahan pe? East of the Mediterranean pe. Jab east of the Mediterranean pe aake unka population bahut zyada badh gaya, around 6 lakh population ho gaya. This 6 lakh population began to fight with the Muslim population residing in that region, means residing in Palestine. Now, after the fight, the Jews population became victorious. After the victory, it was able to exert itself in that region lying in the east of the Mediterranean. So from there, they have been able to adopt an expansionist strategy. And it is because of this expansionism, they are trying to uproot Palestinians completely, even from West Bank and Gaza Strip. Numerous resolutions have been passed in United Nations against the injustice of Israel, against the atrocities of Israel, against the bloodshed that it was unleashing, against the victimization of Palestinians, but these resolutions were always vetoed by United States of America. And why United States of America has supported Israel, I have already made it clear. It was just to contain communism. It was just to support capitalism, the ideology of capitalism. Of late, there has been a changed stance. Of late, United States of America, under Barack Obama, has tried to correct the mistakes that was done by United States of America in the past. How it has tried to correct the mistakes? It has tried to correct the mistakes by keeping itself, by abstaining from vetoing the resolution that was introduced by Egypt, and it was supported by countries like New Zealand, Australia, and some of the countries in Europe. Now these countries have begun to feel how Israel is acting more like an aggressor, how Israel is disregarding the rights of the Palestinians. Now this resolution calls that the kind of the settlements that are being set by the Israel, they're basically illegal. They don't have a legal status. Now what would be the repercussion of this resolution? The repercussion of this resolution would be like the internationally there will be a pressure that will be exerted on Israel to adopt two-state solution, two-state effective solution. Now, what is meant by two-state effective solution? Now, effective here means that you do justice by giving more land to the Palestinians. You do justice by getting back the Israelis in their own land rather than asserting the rights of the Palestinians. Justice here means not bombing and shelling the Palestinian landmarks. Justice here means acting on democratic principles. Justice here means not resorting to aggression. Now this resolution, passing of this resolution, will also help the International Criminal Court to take actions against Israel. So the winds have begun to blow against Israel, but these winds won't be blowing for a very longer period of time. The reason is Donald Trump. The reason is the reverse in the diplomacy of United States of America, that it will be taking place in the January when the new dispensation will be coming in. The new dispensation under Trump will be undoing the good that was done by Barack Obama. It will again be supporting, it will again be succoring the Israeli government, because Trump is basically against the Muslim population. He is against the Muslim realm. That's the reason. So the United States of America will have a new reason to support Israel. In the past, it had the reason of capitalism. Now it will be having the reason of fundamentalism, reason of polarizing the world into others versus Muslims. So this was all for the editorial decode. Now on this editorial, you can aapko kya question pucha ja sakta hai? Critically analyze the importance of the United Nations resolution against the settlements being done by Israel in West Bank and Gaza Strip. Now another question that can be asked, critically analyze the change policy stance of United States of America vis-a-vis Israel and how this will be altering the relationship between United States of America and Israel. Another question would be like, critically analyze the importance of this resolution in India and Israel relationship. What is India's stand on the recent resolution? So these are all the questions that could be asked from this editorial. Now, if you want to read more, please visit brainyias.com on this very issue. You can also read Brainy Map on this very issue on brainyias.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainy IAS. You can find this application from Google Play Store and from App Store. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care.